Shalom. I hope that everybody has been afflicting their souls properly and that your fast has been meaningful. For those that missed last night's service for Kol Nidre, Natasha did an amazing job on the Kol Nidre prayer. And that service is on Facebook, so if you missed it, you can follow along there. This morning's service will also be on Facebook, and so I encourage you to share it with those that you love so that they can experience a little of what you experience on a regular basis. Amen? Let's all stand. Avinu Malkeinu, our Father, our King, we thank you for this Yom Tov, this day, this appointed time of Yom Kippur. Abba, we ask that our hearts would truly turn to you this morning, that all that we do this morning would give glory and honor and praise to you and unite your people as one, that we would become echad, that we would fulfill that prayer that you prayed, that we would be one as you and Abba are one. Father, we ask that you would be glorified today, but that also our hearts would turn to you in a unique way on this moment, this appointed time. And Father, that we would be introspective. We would be searching our hearts through the leading of your Ruach, and that we would repent for anything that would separate us from you today. B'shem Yeshua Meshekinu. Amen. I also wanted to say that this evening we will be gathering for just a very short time here at the synagogue at 6:30 for a Ne'ilah service, and then all those that would like to join us at Fanaris Brothers on Highway 29 to break the fast together are welcome to come and join my wife and I there, as well as some of the others from the congregation. They have plenty of room for all of us, and they have good gyro meat. And I only say that just to add just a little extra affliction to your day. As you think now about the gyro meat at Fanaris Brothers that you won't be able to have until after the sun goes down tonight. So I'm just trying to help. It's just helping out. So that will happen. We will blow the last shofar of the day as we close out the time of Yom Kippur from Rosh Hashanah or Yom Teruah to Yom Kippur together. So that's at 6:30 tonight here. You do not have to dress in any certain way because we will be going afterwards, those that want to Fanaris Brothers. And Fanaris Brothers also serves pasta. And white clothes and pasta is not the best choice. So just consider that. Also, please be in prayer. Noah Heltz had a procedure last night. He was eating yesterday afternoon, and some food got caught in his esophagus. And they had to do a procedure to free him up of that. And he is at the hospital this morning. They're expecting him to go to leave pretty quick, but just be praying for him. Also, for those who know Brittany Greenberg, Joe and Brittany, they spent about a month with us not long ago. They're the oldest son of Mark and Donya, Rabbi Mark and Donya Greenberg. Anyhow, all of that said to say that she is violating the Torah this morning because she is laboring on Yom Kippur, and this morning at about 10 minutes to 8, I got a text message that said, dilated 4 centimeters, she's on the way, and I said, I can't believe you're laboring on Yom Kippur, it's a high holy day, what is wrong with you? And she said, And of course, she's texting me. Her husband, who's not going through labor, is not doing the texting. She is. And I text back and I said, you could have planned better? And she said, I didn't know when I was going to have the baby. I said, but you can count to 9. You know when September is. You could just, you know, plan better. She was not in the mood for my humor. But I do ask that you will pray for her and little Rosie as she comes and is delivered. Actually, I love the way the Bible says it. The Bible says the mom gets delivered, not the baby. I just love the honesty of the Bible. So with that said, we are going to enter into an amazing time of worship this morning as we turn our hearts to the Lord and worship and praise Him. Oh, that's right. Cheryl, I had to process my hard drive slower with names. Cheryl is having knee surgery tomorrow morning. Are they doing one or both?
Just one.
Just one. So be praying for her tomorrow morning for everything to go smoothly and for quick recovery. Amen.
So, I'm not going to wish you all a happy Yom Kippur. I guess I'm supposed to wish you all an easy fast, but I'm not going to do that either because that kind of defeats the purpose of it. You know, physical fasting, it gives your body a chance to repair and heal itself, and on a spiritual level, it draws us closer to God and facilitates the healing of our souls when done with the right heart. Amen? Repent then and turn to God so that your sins may be wiped out, that times of refreshing may come from the Lord.
And I'm all we need. Thank you. Mato.
And it is written, rejoice in the Lord, you righteous ones. It is befitting for the upright to praise him. By the mouth of the upright you shall be lauded. By the words of the righteous you shall be blessed. By the tongue of the pious you shall be exalted. And in the midst of the holy ones you shall be sanctified. May your name be praised forever, O our King. Unto you we offer blessings and thanksgiving from this time forward. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King exalted through praises, God of thanksgiving, Master of wonders, who accepts musical songs of praise, King, God, giver of life to the world. From Leviticus 23:27-28. However, the tenth day of the seventh month is Yom Kippur, a holy convocation to you. So you are to afflict yourselves. You are to bring an offering made by fire to Adonai. You are not to do any kind of work on that set day, for it is Yom Kippur, to make atonement for you before Adonai, your God. Leviticus 26:40-42. But if they confess their iniquity and that of their fathers, in the treachery they committed against me, and how they walked contrary to me, I walked contrary to them and brought them into the land of their enemies. And if at that time their uncircumcised heart becomes humbled, so they accept the punishment for their iniquity, then I will remember my covenant with Jacob, and also my covenant with Isaac, and my covenant with Abraham, and I will remember the land. Isaiah 43:25-26. I am the one who blots out your transgressions for my own sake, and I will not remember your sins. Remind me when we argue our case together. State your case so that you may be proved right. For if the blood of goats and bulls and the ashes of a heifer, sprinkling those who have been defiled, sanctify for the cleansing of the flesh, how much more will the blood of Messiah, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without blemish to God, cleanse our conscience from dead works to serve the living God? That's Hebrews 9:13-14. 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and righteous to forgive our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. The King sitting on a throne, high and lifted up, HaMelech HaYoshev Al Kisei Ram V'Nisa. Bless the Lord, the Blessed One.
Bless the Lord, the Blessed One.
Baruch Hu Et Adonai HaMevorach. Please stand. Romans 1:7. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Yeshua the Messiah. Isaiah 33:5. Adonai is exalted, for he dwells on high. He has filled Zion with justice and righteousness. For Adonai is our judge, Adonai is our lawgiver, Adonai is our king, he who will save us. The Lord is king, the Lord was king, the Lord shall be king forever and ever. Adonai Melech, Adonai Malach, Adonai Yimloch, Le'olam Va'ed. You hold the universe together, the Lord is King. You establish heaven and earth, the Lord is King. You created man in your image, the Lord is King. The seraphim and all heaven declare, the Lord is King. The psalms sing out, the Lord is King. Your people declare in never-ending worship, the Lord is King. Prayers arise continually because the Lord is King. May all our works declare, the Lord is King. Oh, let everything that has breath praise the Lord, the King. The Lord is King, the Lord was King, the Lord shall be King forever. Our God and God of our fathers, the kingdom of God is within us. We declare that Yeshua, he is king, and his kingdom shall rule in our lives. Of him it was written, this is Yeshua, the king of the Jews. With love and devotion, we will follow him and keep his commands. We will love you with all our heart, soul, and strength, as we love our neighbor as ourselves. We will bring the good news of salvation to all who will receive it. For you are coming again with judgment, and in that day all the earth shall know that you are King of kings and Lord of lords. Psalms 22:28. For the kingdom belongs to Adonai, and he rules over the nations. Isaiah 44:6. Thus says Adonai, Israel's king, and his redeemer Adonai said, Oh, I am the first and the last, and there is no God beside me. Psalms 24:8-10. Who is this King of glory? Adonai, strong and mighty. Adonai, mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O gates, and lift them up, you everlasting doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? Adonai Sabaoth. He is the King of glory. Salah. King of the universe, let your kingdom be established in us. We acknowledge your rulership not only with our lips, but also with our lives. May we bend our will to conform to yours, and may our hearts find delight in serving you. May our every act proclaim, the Lord God of Israel is King, and his kingdom rules over all. Adonai, Adonai, the compassionate and gracious God, slow to anger and abundant in loving kindness and truth, showing mercy to a thousand generations, forgiving iniquity and transgression and sin. The pardon for our sins has been provided for us by the atoning work of the shed blood of our Messiah, Yeshua. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who has given us the way of salvation in Messiah Yeshua. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher natalanu et derech Yeshua, v'mashiach Yeshua. Amen. He is Lord, he is Lord. Yeshua HaMashiach, he is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Yeshua HaMashiach, he is Lord.
Lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up, you everlasting doors,
that the King of Glory may come in. Who is this King of Glory? Adonai, strong and mighty. Adonai, mighty in battle. Lift up your heads, O gates, and lift them up, you everlasting doors, that the King of Glory may come in. Who is this King of Glory? Adonai Sabaoth. He is the King of Glory. Selah. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall declare your praises. Adonai Svatai Tivtak Yafi Yagi Tehilatetha. Blessed are you, Lord our God, and God of our fathers, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, and God of Jacob, the great, mighty, and awesome God, the Most High God, who bestows grace and creates all, and remembers the righteousness of the fathers, and brings a Redeemer to their children's children for his name's sake with love. You have remembered us unto life, O King who delights in life, and you have written us in the book of life. For your sake, O God of life, we rejoice that our names are written in the Lamb's book of life. O King, Helper, Savior, and Shield, blessed are you, O Lord, Shield of Abraham. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu, Elohei Avotenu, Elohei Abraham, Elohei Yitzchak, Elohei Yaakov, Ha'el Ha'gadol, Ha'gibor, Ha'nora, El Elyon, Do'el Chasadim Tovim, Ve'konei Ha'kol, Ve'zocher Chasdei Avot. Uphold the fallen, heal the sick, set free those in bondage, and keep faith with those that sleep in the dust. Who is like you, master of mighty deeds? And who can compare to you, King, who causes death, restores life, and makes salvation strive? And you are faithful to resurrect the dead. Blessed are you, O Lord, who resurrects the dead. Atagi bor the lama adonai, metaye me. So make no thing for Ophelim, Umatir Asurim, Umkayem Emunato, Lishene Afar, Ikamo Kavagiro, Umido Mela, Melakri, Umkaye, Umasmi Ak Yeshua, Menema. We will sanctify your name in this world, even as it is sanctified in the heavens above. As it is written by your prophet, and they call to each other, saying,
Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory.
Those facing them say, Blessed.
Blessed is the Lord of the Lord from his abiding place. Blessed.
From your heavenly abode you will appear, O our King, and reign over us, for we wait for you. When will you reign in Zion? Soon, even in our days, may you dwell there forever and ever. May you be exalted and sanctified within Jerusalem, your city, from generation to generation and for all eternity. May our eyes see your kingdom as it expressing the songs of your might by the hand of David, your righteous anointed. The Lord shall reign forever, your God, O Zion, from generation to generation. Hallelujah. Nekadeshet shim kabelam, tishem shemakti shim oto bishmei marom, kakatu vayad nevietha, bekara zel zeve amar.
Adosh, adosh, adosh.
by unclean speech, and for the sin we've committed against you by foolish thought, for the sin we've committed against you through evil inclination, and for the sin we've committed against you knowingly and unknowingly. For all these sins, O God, forgive us and pardon us in Yeshua's name. Ba'al kulam elohai shlichot, salat kulanu, ba'chal lanu, b'shem Yeshua. For the sin we've committed against you by denying and lying, for the sin we've committed against you by bribery, for the sin we've committed against you by scoffing, for the sin we've committed against you by slander, for the sin we've committed against you in our business dealings, and for the sin we've committed against you in eating and in drinking, for the sin we've committed against you by demanding usurious interest, and for the sin we've committed against you by arrogance and pride, for the sin we've committed against you by speaking gossip, and for the sin we've committed against you by wanton glances, for the sin we've committed against you with haughty eyes, and for the sin we've committed against you by insolence. For all these sins, O God of forgiveness, forgive us and pardon us in Yeshua's name. Ba'al kulam elohai shlichot, salat kulanu, machal lanu, b'shem Yeshua. For the sin we've committed against you by rejecting responsibility, and for the sin we've committed against you by contentiousness, for the sin we've committed against you by ensnaring our neighbor, and for the sin we've committed against you by envy, for the sin we've committed against you by levity, and for the sin we've committed against you by being stiff-necked, for the sin we've committed against you by running to do evil, and for the sin we've committed against you by talebearing, for the sin we've committed against you by vain oaths, and for the sin we've committed against you by hatred without cause, for the sin we've committed against you by breach of trust, and for the sin we've committed against you with confusion of mind. For all these things, O God, forgiveness. Forgive us and pardon us in Yeshua's name. Ba'al kulam elohai shlichot, salach lanu, machal lanu, b'shem Yeshua. And now the Ashamu, which is the guilt prayers. We prayed first about sin, and we understand that you can be forgiven of sin, but not cleansed of guilt. And so now we will recite these prayers together. We have trespassed, we have dealt deceitfully, we have stolen, and we have slandered. We have acted perversely, we have done wrong, we have acted presumptuously, and we have been violent. We have spoken lies, we have spoken evil, we have spoken falsely, and we have blasphemed. We have scoffed, and we have rebelled, we have provoked, and we have oppressed. We have been stiff-necked, we have corrupted, we have gone astray, and we have led others astray. But if we confess our sins, you are faithful and just to forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Our Father, our King, be merciful and answer us. Though we have no worthy deeds, treat us charitably with loving kindness, for you have saved us. Our Father, our King, our Father, our King, we pray for your grace for Israel, your people, and that you would grant unto us forgiveness for our sins, pardon for our transgressions. Our deeds cannot save us, and we are not righteous except by the blood of the Lamb. Our deeds cannot save us, and we are not righteous except by the blood of the Lamb. Our Father, our King, our Father, our King, we pray grace. Pray for your grace for Israel, your people, that they would come to know you. Our hearts are turned toward you in love and reverence. We pray Israel will see in her darkness he who has died for her sins. We pray Israel will see in her darkness he who has died for her sins. Our Father, our King, there is no God but you. Have mercy on Israel. Deliver her from her distress and bring her to faith in Messiah Yeshua. Our Father, our King, bring peace to the earth through the Sar Shalom, the Prince of Peace, Messiah Yeshua.
Our Father, our King, stand us for the resurrection of today, and the merit of Yeshua's return.
Our Father, our King, let your Spirit be poured out in end-time revival, and let the harvest be gathered with the remnant of Israel coming to salvation.
Our Father, our King, let your judgments fall on the country.
Father, our King, send us not away empty-handed from your presence. Our God and God of our fathers, you have given us this day as a time to examine and judge ourselves, to joyfully bring harvest offerings to you, and to look forward to Messiah's return. We remember Yeshua, our great high priest, who brought his own precious blood, the blood of atonement, into your most holy place. Through his blood, which cleanses us from sin, we now have our consciences purified from guilt and condemnation, and can serve you in love and with pure devotion. You will bring this age to a close with the shofar call, heralding a new age. Then nations shall learn to roar no more. The wolf and the lamb shall lay down together in peace, and your name shall be one over all the earth. In that day Israel shall be delivered and dwell in peace, and all the nations shall come to your light. The new Jerusalem and the new temple will be established with priests and Levites from among all peoples. And from one new moon to another, and from one Shabbat to another, and on the appointed season of Sukkot, all flesh shall come to worship before you. We dedicate ourselves to you today for the for your purposes as living sacrifices. We consecrate ourselves to you, and we will seek your will. Wherever you want us to go, we will go. Whatever you want us to do, we will do. And whatever you want us to say, we will say. If there is anything you want us to change, show us, and we will do it. We seek you and desire your anointing, your manifest presence that breaks every yoke. Let it rest upon us, and we will be victorious. Now take a few minutes for personal meditation or confession. You can be seated to do so. Please join with me as we read together. You may stay seated. Our God and God of our fathers, you have bestowed a great love upon us that we should be called the children of God. We have entered your kingdom by humbling ourselves, turning toward you in repentance and becoming as little children. Abba, Father, we come before you today to receive your love anew, a love that never fails, and to experience the wonderful truth that we are accepted in the beloved. We come in faith to you, declaring, desiring freedom in our lives from past hurts and disappointments. We make the choice today to forgive our earthly fathers for every way in which they failed to be the father to us that you called them to be. I release my father to you and forgive you. I believe what your word says about you as my heavenly father. I receive your unconditional love. I declare that the enemy's power of rejection is broken over me. Bless me, enlarge my territory, and keep me from evil. Give me fresh vision, heal my heart, and fill me with your love, joy, and peace. In Yeshua's name, amen. Our God and God of our fathers, vision is one of our most valuable possessions, and we desire to increase it. We want to know our purpose and to see our vision grow and fulfill it. We will resist discouragement as it comes to blind us and cause us to lose our vision. We will resist fear, knowing that fear is not of you, and that it will keep us from fulfilling our destiny. But we will walk in faith, knowing that you are with us, and abiding with you, we will always see the way to go. We will fear only you, and will not fear anything else. We will follow our vision as far as we can see. The walls of fear around us and fences, which are delusions, will not be able to stop us. As long as we can see further, you will always provide us with food and water we need for our journey. Let hunger and thirst keep us from moving forward. When we find refreshment, let us rest as long as they last, and then keep going. We will not let wounds or mistakes suffered on the journey turn us back, or return to bondage because of disappointments or failures. We choose faith over fear, and we'll keep going until we reach our destiny. Thank you for the patience and discipline we need to endure. For the greatest treasure is at the end of the longest, most difficult journey. We have faith in the Holy Spirit's ability to lead us into all truth, over the enemy's power to deceive. We will walk in our vision, knowing that if we don't follow it, we will lose it. Many are called, but few are chosen. Many will come to the wedding feast, but few will be the bride. Bless Adonai, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless Adonai, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. He forgives all your iniquity. He heals all your diseases. He redeems your life from the pit. He crowns you with loving kindness and compassion. Please rise for our Torah service. And if the children will make their way to the front. Vayehi b'Yitzhak Aharon, vayomer Moshe, kum Adonai, ve'yachutzu oylecha, ve'yanusu misanecha, mipanecha, ki mitzion, Jerusalem, Baruch Shema. and that hate you flee from before you. For from Zion will go forth the Torah, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. Blessed be he who in his holiness gave the Torah to his people Israel. Amen. We're going to bless our children and then send them back to their parents. Then, of course, we'll have to bless our parents. Abba, Father, we just thank you for the gift of our children, for their life and their energy, for their enthusiasm and their joy. Abba, we as parents and adults have so much to learn from our children. We ask that you'll bless them with the knowledge of who Yeshua is and a relationship with him. And Father, help them to be world changers for you. B'shem Yeshua Meshachenu. Amen. And they shall now return to their parents or the nursery. The blessing before reading from the Torah. Baruch Hu et Adonai Hamavorach.
Baruch Adonai Hamavorach
Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch Adonai Hamavorach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam. Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Ha'amim. Benatam Lanu et Torato. Baruch Adonai. Blessed are you, O Lord, giver of the Torah. We're reading from Leviticus chapter 16, from verse 29. It is to be a statute to you forever, that in the seventh month, on the tenth day of the month, you are to afflict your souls and do no kind of work, both the native-born and the outsider dwelling among you. For on this day atonement will be made for you to cleanse you from all your sins. You will be clean before Adonai. It is a Shabbat of solemn rest to you, and you are to afflict your souls. It is a statute forever. The Kohen who is anointed and who is consecrated to be Kohen in his father's place will make the atonement and put on the linen garments, the holy garments. He is to make atonement for the holy sanctuary, for the tent of meeting, for the altar, for the Kohanim, and for all the people of the assembly. This will be an everlasting statute for you to make atonement for Bnei Israel once in the year because of all their sins. It was done as Adonai commanded Moses. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natan lanu Torat emet v'chaye olam nata b'tochenu. Baruch atah Adonai notem ha'Torah. And has planted eternal life in our midst. Blessed are you, O Lord, giver of the Torah.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher bachar b'vim tovim v'netzah b'divrehem hanei morim be'emet. Baruch atah Adonai ha'bokher b'Torah u'mashe'ado u'b'Yisrael amon u'vim b'yei hanei me'chazeh. selected good prophets and was pleased with their words, which were spoken truthfully. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, who chooses the Torah, your servant Moses, your people Israel, and prophets of truth and righteousness. Reading this morning is from Isaiah 58, 6-12. Is not this the fast I choose? To release the bonds of wickedness, to untie the cords of the yoke, to let the oppressed go free, and to tear off every yoke. Is it not to share your bread with the hungry, to bring the homeless poor into your house? When you see the naked, to cover him, and not hide yourself from your own flesh and blood. Then your light will break forth like the dawn, and your healing will spring up speedily. Your righteousness will go before you, the glory of Adonai as your rear guard. Then you will call, and Adonai will answer. You will cry, and he will say, here I am. If you get rid of the oak among you, finger pointing and bad mouthing. If you give yourself to the hungry and satisfy the desire of the afflicted, then your light will rise in darkness, and your gloom will be like the midday. Then Adonai will guide you continually, satisfy your soul in drought, and strengthen your bones. It will be like a watered garden, like a spring of water, whose waters never fail. Some of you will rebuild the ancient ruins, will raise up the aged old foundations, will be called repairer of the breach, restorer of streets for dwelling. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam. Zoreh kol havoah means tzadik b'kol haroh. Hayel ha'neman ha'omer ve'yoseh. Hamdiber m'chayim. Shekol divarah b'med mazadeh. Ne'eman atahu Adonai Eloheinu. B'nei ha'minim divarecha. B'nebar? Ekar. B'barecha. Akorlo yishuv rekam. Ki'am ne'eman v'rach amantah. Baruch atah Adonai hayel ha'neman b'kol divarah. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, Rock of all eternities, faithful in all generations, a trustworthy God, who says and does, who speaks and makes it come to pass, all of whose words are true and righteous. Faithful are you, O Lord our God, and faithful are your words, and not one word of yours is turned back unfulfilled, for you are a faithful and compassionate God and King. Blessed are you, O Lord, the God who is faithful.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, Hashem atzal lanu, Mashiach Yeshua, v'hadibrit shel habrit hakadosha. Baruch atah Adonai atein habrit hakadosha. Blessed are you, Lord God, King of the universe, who has given us Messiah Yeshua and the words of the new covenant. Blessed are you, O Lord, giver of the new covenant. Hebrews 10:1-13. The Torah has a shadow of the good things to come, not the form itself of the realities. For this reason, it can never, by means of the same sacrifices they offer constantly, year after year, make perfect those who draw near. Otherwise, would they not have ceased to be offered, since the worshippers, cleansed once and for all, would no longer have consciousness of sins. But in these sacrifices is a reminder of sins year after year, for it is impossible for the blood of bulls and goats to take away sins. So when Messiah comes into the world, he says, sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me. In whole burnt offerings and sin offerings you did not delight. Then I said, behold, I come to do your will, O God, in the scroll of the book it is written of me. After saying above, sacrifices and offerings and whole burnt offerings and sin offerings you did not desire, nor did you delight in them, those which are offered according to Torah. Then he said, behold, I come to do your will. He takes away the first to establish the second. All time, a single sacrifice for sins, he sat down at the right hand of God, waiting from then on until his enemies are made a footstool for his feet. Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe, who has given us the word of truth and has planted life everlasting in our midst. Blessed are you, O Lord, giver of the new covenant.
Yom Kippur, and we're all spending the day, or should be all spending our day, thinking about and meditating on the Lord, on the things of the Lord. There is a certain dynamic that takes place in the Messianic community on Yom Kippur, which actually the entire book of Hebrews is written so that we would understand the place of Yom Kippur in the life of a believer. Now it's important, by the way, before I go on, I wanted to welcome Pastor Arnie from Freedom Church here this morning. I don't want to draw attention to him, he's in the third row from the back. So, but welcome, my friend. There are a couple of things I want to talk about. I want to read from Leviticus chapter 23, and then we'll read several other scriptures. I promise that I'm only going to take long enough to cause you to have an afflicted soul. Verse 27, also on the 10th day of the 7th month there shall be a day of atonement. It shall be a holy gathering to you, and you shall afflict your souls and offer an offering made by fire to the Lord. And you shall do no work in that same day, for it is a day of atonement to make an atonement for you before the Lord your God. For whatever soul it is who shall not be afflicted in that same day, he shall be cut off from among his people. And whatsoever soul it is who does any work on the same day, the same soul I shall destroy from among his people. You shall do no kind of work. It shall be a statute forever throughout your generations in all your dwelling. It shall be a Sabbath of rest, and you shall afflict your souls in the 9th day of the month at evening. From evening to evening shall you celebrate your Shabbat. Now I want to point out just little side notes here as we go along. One is that we understand from this verse and many other verses that our day biblically begins in the evening, not at midnight, not at sunlight, but in the evening the day begins. And so we're to afflict our souls on this day. We are to fast. We are to allow our bodies to become weakened physically so that we can become stronger and more attuned spiritually. And we spend a lot of time on this. Now, I said the book of Hebrews was written directly about this, because when we read the book of Hebrews, it is all talking about this particular day and this particular day's relationship to believers in Yeshua. Now, remember, the book of Hebrews was written when? Somewhere between 65 and 68. Shortly before the destruction of the temple, but about 30 years after the death of Yeshua. And yet all of the believers were still participating in the sacrificial system, in observing the Moedim, the feasts and festivals, and they're discussing in the book of Hebrews, how does this affect us so that we can teach this and share it to others? I don't know how many times I get phone calls from young leaders. I used to say new leaders, because I'd avoid the word young because that means I'm not young. But I've given up on that since AARP sent me a card. I didn't join AARP, but they did send me it, so clearly they believe I'm old. But I get phone calls from young leaders who are asked questions about this. How do we observe? Why do we observe? What, you know, if the perfect sacrifice was made, why do we need to gather together and observe this day at all? If our sins have been atoned for, why are we celebrating this day which was required in order to have atonement? What is the purpose? What is the reason? And every young leader and many times old leaders get asked these questions by new people coming into the community. They aren't asking these questions to be argumentative, at least most of them aren't. They aren't asking them to be aggravating. They're not asking them to test us to see if we are right or think we're right or have answers. They're curious about how this affects us as believers in Yeshua. And I know that there are those here this morning that may not have had any of those questions until I just asked them, and now you're wondering about all of those things. Why do we do this? Well, you know, he died, he put the blood in the heavenly, it's already taken care of. Why are we doing this? And I want to answer that question this morning, not from Leviticus 23, but from two chapters over in Leviticus 25. And so if you have your Bibles or your cell phone, just flip over two pages. And the Lord spoke to Moses in Mount Sinai, saying, "Speak to the people of Israel and say to them, when you come into the land which I give you, then shall the land keep a Sabbath to the Lord. 6 years you shall sow your field, and 6 years you shall prune your vineyard and gather its fruit. But in the seventh year shall be a Sabbath of rest to the land, a Sabbath for the Lord. You shall not sow your field nor prune your vineyard. That which grows of its own accord of your harvest you shall not reap, nor gather the grapes of your vine undressed, for it is a year of rest to the land. The Sabbath produce of the land shall be food for you, and for your servant, and for your maid, and for your hired servant, for the stranger who sojourns with you. For your cattle and for the beasts that are in your land shall it all its produce be. And you shall count 7 Sabbaths of years to you, 7 times 7 years. The space of the 7 Sabbaths of years shall be to you 40 and 9 years. Now, I love that. In particular verse I love because it says it 3 different ways. It's like the Lord knew we were going to ask the question, so we went ahead and answered it a second time. And then he knew we'd ask the third question, so we answered it a third time. You're going to count 7, so you've got 7 of 7. It's going to be 49 years. And then shall you cause the shofar to sound on the 10th day of the 7th month, in the Day of Atonement. Shall you sound the shofar throughout all your land, and you shall hallow the 50th year and proclaim liberty throughout the land to all the inhabitants of it. It shall be a jubilee to you, and you shall return every man to his possession, and you shall return every man to his family. A jubilee shall that 50th year be to you. You shall not sow nor reap that which grows of itself in it, nor gather the grapes in it of your vine undressed. For it is a jubilee, and it shall be holy to you, and you shall eat the produce of it out of its field. In the year of jubilee you shall return every man to his possession. If you sell something to your neighbor or buy something from your neighbor's hand, you shall not defraud one another according to the number of years after the jubilee. And according to the number of years of fruits he shall sow to you, according to the multitude of years it shall increase its price. If the years are few, you shall accordingly diminish its price, and according to the number of years of the fruits that he sells you. You shall not therefore defraud one another, but you shall fear your Lord, for I am the Lord your God. Now, most of the time, when we talk about Yom Kippur, or technically Yom HaKippurim, which is plural, and I think the reason it's plural is because it reminds us that there's two things that go on for that atonement. One is the atonement that took place every year here, and one is the eternal atonement that would happen when Yeshua put the blood on the mercy seat. Now, we think of that in terms of year after year after year. I'm 56? No? Okay. I'm 56, so I've done this 56 times. And each year, we celebrate Yom HaKippurim. But from the very foundation of the earth, in the space of time where there is no time, Yom HaKippurim was already fulfilled. And if we have our mind only on what's happening on the earth, we will fail to see what happened in the heaven. And so when we celebrate Yom HaKippurim, when my family gathered each year at our synagogue growing up, and we spent 23 hours in synagogue listening to prayers just like we prayed, only all of them done in Hebrew, a language which I did not fully understand, for 23 hours. You think afflicting your soul is a 45-minute message? 23. We went from service to service to service and no food. And it was all about repentance, which is wonderful. And please don't take what I'm saying as if repentance isn't a wonderful thing and a mechanism that God gave so that we could have restoration. But I don't remember once in all of my years in a traditional synagogue anyone mentioning the other part of Yom Kippur. The part at which there is freedom proclaimed. The part at which the completed work of Yom Kippur is proclaimed. When we read in Luke chapter 4, technology is wonderful until you use it. Luke chapter 4, beginning at verse 16. And he came to Nazareth, where he had been raised, as was his custom. And he went into the synagogue on Shabbat, and he got up to read. When the scroll of the prophet Yeshayahu or Isaiah was handed to him, he unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Ruach Adonai, the Spirit of God, is on me, because he has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set free the oppressed, to proclaim the year of Adonai's favor." He closed the scroll and gave it back to the attendant and sat down. All the eyes of the synagogue were on him. And then he began to tell them, "Today this scripture has been fulfilled in your ears." All were speaking well of him and marveled at the gracious words coming out of his mouth. And they were saying, "Isn't this the son of Joseph?" But he said to them, "Doubtless you will say to me this proverb, 'Doctor, heal yourself. What have we heard was done at Capernaum? Do so as so much here in your hometown.' But he said, 'Truly I tell you, no prophet is except in his own hometown. But with all truthfulness I say to you, that there were many widows in Israel in the days of Elijah, when the heavens were closed for 3.5 years. And there came a great famine over all the land. Elijah was sent forth, not sent to any of them, but only to Zarephath in the land of Sidon, to the widowed woman. There were many Basaramat in Israel in the time of Elijah the prophet, and none of them were purified apart from Naaman the Syrian." Now all in the synagogue were filled with rage upon hearing these things. How quickly it went from, "Well, this guy's awesome," to, "Man, we hate him." In moments. Now listen, these verses in Luke are absolutely prophetic. is not only prophetic because he is reading from Yeshayahu, from Isaiah, where Isaiah talks about this day, this Yovel, this day of the release, this day of freeing the captives and setting things right. But he's also talking about how the people that were there with him didn't recognize who he was. He proclaimed to them, I am the one. This day, this is fulfilled in your ears. And they would not and did not recognize the Messiah in their midst. And because they didn't recognize the Messiah, they also could not receive the deliverance. And he said, it's just like when Elijah was here. He came and he was proclaiming freedom and deliverance and repentance and restoration and all the promises of God, but you wouldn't receive it. So where did I have to go? To the nations. And the people of the nations received the message of Messiah. And the same thing happened in Yeshua's day. He came, and our Jewish people, my Jewish people, some of them accepted him. Yes, we know that there were Pharisees that accepted him. We know there were Sadducees that quit being Sadducees and accepted him. We know that there were priests that turned to him. We know there were regular Israelites that were just normal, regular people that accepted him. Hundreds of thousands, but there were so many more that could not receive him because he didn't come as they expected him to come. And today in synagogues all over the world, there are Jewish people that are gathered together on this holy day. And they're turning their hearts to the Lord many times much more dramatically, meaningfully than many of us do when we gather together in our synagogues and churches. They're crying from the depths of their souls, tearfully repenting for their sins and the sins of their nation. But unfortunately, they don't see the second part of the Kippurim, what Yeshua had done when he applied permanently, once and for all, the blood to the mercy seat. When he fulfilled the role of high priest once and for all. Now, that didn't mean it did away with all of the year to year to year. It still was going on. 30 years afterwards, not once in the book of Hebrews does the writer say, you bunch of dummies, you missed it. You shouldn't be doing this anymore. He doesn't say that. He does explain to them that there has been deliverance and freedom. We read from Hebrews this morning, or Lori did. And just after that, in Hebrews 10, it says, because of Yeshua, we can now boldly enter into the holy place. Why? Because his offering reversed the reason we couldn't. Understand that before the sin of Israel, of the golden calf, before all that happened, the high priest in Israel could draw near anytime they wanted to. The high priest could go into the Holy of Holies anytime he wanted to. But with that happening, with the Nadab and Abihu, with all that happened, with the sins of Israel, God said, from now on, you'll only come when I call you. And with Yeshua's death and him becoming the veil, his flesh became that veil. It made it so now we could boldly enter into the holy place. We don't have to have an intermediary that's going to do it for us, because our intermediary has done it for us. And now we can boldly go into that holy place. In Ephesians chapter 1, says this, after you heard the message of truth, the good news of your salvation, the reason this is so important, remember, when a word is used, when a phrase is used in the scripture, and then we see that same phrase used in the scripture again, we know that the phrase reflects and reverts to the other one. We can connect the phrases. In other words, if we want to understand what they're talking about in Ephesians 1, where it talks about the good news of salvation, we have to look back before and see where else that phrase was used. And it's used in Isaiah 61, and it's used in the verses that the Messiah quoted on that day leading up to Yom Kippur. It said, I preach good news. It says, after you heard the message of truth, the good news of your salvation, and when you put your trust in Him, you were sealed with the promised Ruach HaKodesh. He is the guarantee of our inheritance until the redemption of His possession to His glorious praise. On Yom Kippur today, Jewish people all over the world are gathered together in synagogues and sanctuaries like this one. And they're greeting each other with the words, may your name be sealed for a good year. In other words, when the book's closed and sealed, that your name is inside. But that's not how it works. The way our name is sealed is because of what Yeshua did, and the good news of our salvation isn't just that we have atonement, but that we have been set free and restored. It's not just that we get to feel bad. It's that we're supposed to feel great. We're supposed to feel bad about our sin, but great because He is greater than our sin. Because He proclaimed this day, this has been done, this is completed, it's finished. I am the one that can set you free. It's not about being in bondage to sin. Too many of us live our lives weighted down by the sin of our past instead of being set free from the debt of sin. He paid our debt. And when He paid our debt, the book of life was sealed, and our name is inside. And we don't have to go from year to year hoping and wondering, maybe if I just behave well enough, maybe if I cry enough in repentance, maybe if I say the prayers just right, maybe if I do everything just perfectly, maybe if I fix every relationship in my life. And let me say this. We should try to do all of those things.
Amen.
But not one of those things will cause your name to be sealed in the book of life. It doesn't mean we shouldn't do them. We should show our faith by our good works. We should live according to the Torah because of that. Not once in the book of Hebrews, which is all about this day. A whole book in the Bible that was written just so we would understand that we should do all of that, but not without understanding that the good news of our salvation is that we have been sealed because of our faith, our trust. It says, after you heard the message of truth, the good news of your salvation, and when you put your trust in Him, you are sealed with the promise of the Ruach HaKodesh. He is the guarantee of our inheritance until the redemption of His possession to His glorious praise. You see, we as believers in Yeshua absolutely should observe every one of the feasts and festivals.
Amen.
Every one of the appointed times, without exception.
Amen.
We should live our lives just as the early believers do, and emulate and follow their example and the example of our Messiah. But we should understand that if we did everything perfectly and weren't sealed by faith, the end result is as if we had never done it. because it's not something we can do. It's something we have to understand has been done. It says above that, verse 9, He made known to us the mystery of His will, in keeping with His good pleasure that He planned in Messiah. The plan of the fullness of times is to bring all things together in Messiah, both the things in heaven and the things on earth in Him. In the fullness of time, those of us doing the earthly things, the heavenly things will be brought together and they will become one. What happens if believers aren't doing the earthly things? What do we lose if when He says that the fullness of times is going to bring all things together in the Messiah, both the heavenly and the earthly? In Him we are chosen, predestined according to His will. He keeps working out all things according to the purpose of His will so that we who were first to put our hope in Messiah might be for His glorious praise. And then He says, after you've heard the message of truth, the good news of your salvation, after we understand why He read that scroll from Isaiah 61 and why He said, this day this is fulfilled, He would have read that just a few days ago when that reading was, as it led up to Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. He said, this day, this, I'm proclaiming this is the year of Yovel, this is the year of release. I'm proclaiming that when this year is done, when all of this is over, when the blood is applied, when I have become the perfect sacrifice for your sins, then you will be sealed. And it's a promise of an inheritance that we have. And too many of us don't walk in the blessings of the Jubilee simply because we don't understand the truth of being set free. We hang on to our past and our sin. We hang on to the doubt and unbelief that comes with that. We listen to the lies of the enemy who binds us by telling us that it isn't complete. That we have to do something. That something more has to happen in order for His blood to be good enough for my sin. But it's just not true. None of us will ever be able to do anything good enough to accomplish atonement for ourselves. It's only because of what He did. In Ephesians, when He proclaimed this, He was connecting it to Luke, connecting it to Isaiah, and connecting it to the very first verses in the Bible where God established these days as appointed times so that when things are brought together from the heavenly and the earthly, the oneness will happen and the fullness will happen that's been promised to us. I don't know about you, I'm looking forward to that time. And every year when I observe these holy days, I'm doing it because I'm doing my part to bring about the fullness of what He's already done so the heavenly can connect with the earthly. If we're not doing the earthly, the heavenly can't connect with it. At least not in our lives. Let's all stand. Abba, Father. Abba, Father. I just ask that this morning, as your people are gathered here and around the world, that first those within this room will would understand and recognize and come to terms that they have been made new. That when Yeshua proclaimed the freedom to the captive, that they were made free. That nothing is required from them to be released because they weren't able to pay the debt, only He was. And Father, that they would then set aside all of the lies and deceit of the enemy and walk in freedom beginning today. And Father, even more than that, I pray for those that are gathered at Temple Bethel and B'nai Israel this morning and all day today. And Father, as they celebrate Yom Kippur, I ask that you'll reveal Yom HaKippurim, that you'll reveal the plurality of it, the heavenly aspect, the part that can only be fulfilled from you. And Father, that their eyes will be opened to the reality of Yeshua as their Messiah. And that this day they would come in understanding and contact with the atonement that comes only through the shed blood of Yeshua. And Father, beyond that, to Jews around the world and in Israel, reveal yourself to them on this day when their hearts are tender. Reveal Yeshua as the perfect atonement, as the Messiah of Israel. B'shem Yeshua Meshachinu. Amen. Now, you may be seated. On Yom Kippur, a portion of our service is a remembrance service. And so I'm going to ask only those that lost a loved one between last Yom Kippur and this Yom Kippur to stand up. O Lord, what is man that you know him, and the son of man that you esteem him? Man is like to vanity, his days are like a shadow that passes. What is man that you remember him, and the son of man that you visit him? For you have made him a little lower than God, and you have crowned him with glory and honor. O God and God of our fathers, since ancient times you have called us to times of memorial. Times of remembrance. Yom HaKippurim is one of the seasons of memorial that you gave us in your word. We're called to remember your great works, your mighty salvations. We're called to remember that only in living by faith, trusting in you all things, in all things can you be pleased. And we're asked to do it without murmuring the sin which caused our ancestors to miss entering into the promised land. As we trust in you now, knowing that all things work together for good to those who love you and are called according to your purpose. We have peace as we remember our loved ones who have passed on before us. We remember the good that they did and what we learned from them. May the memory of those whom we recall this day influence our lives for good and lead our thoughts away from the vain, the fleeting, to that which is eternal. As we remember their virtues, let us be motivated to devote ourselves to the Great Commission and to live holy lives that are pleasing to you. In this way, the memory of them will continue to bring forth much fruit. We know that we cannot change the past, but teach us to live godly lives now through the power of the Holy Spirit. Help us to live wisely and unselfishly, courageously and fruitfully, in truth and understanding and love and peace, so that those who come after us may remember us for good as we affectionately remember those who came before us. Lord, we now honor those of our parents who've gone before us, thinking of the positive and the good that we had in our relationships with them. We remember other relatives and friends who influenced our lives for good and who are now partaking of their eternal rewards. As we take a moment now to remember these individuals, those of us whose parents are still with us can express thankfulness to you. and think of ways they might be able to please and honor and bless their parents this time. We want to take a moment to lovingly remember the good that we recall about those who nurture us and honor those memories. Life has meaning. Life has plan and purpose. Man was not created only to perish, but to have life and have it more abundantly. You made us, Lord, a little lower than yourself, and you crowned us with glory and honor. We thank you, Lord, for the great salvation you have given us in Messiah Yeshua. Hallelujah. You are worthy of praise and adoration. Hallelujah. You have given us the victory over death. Hallelujah. Yikadal Yikadash Meraba El Mahdi Rakir Tevi Amlik Mokite Achai Tony Yomathon of Chayet Kobek Israel Adalad is Man Karif Imru Amen. Hishme Rabba Mavorak Lalam Lom Yamai Yiparakvi Shabakvi Arvi Mamavi Nasay Yitadarvi Levi Dalal Shme Kudisha Brihu Let Loving Kobir Katavishirata Tushpatata and Ephamata Damiramba Amav Imru Amen. Yehi Shalom Rab Min Shemai V'Chaim Aleinu V'Alkol Yisrael V'Emru Amen. Osei Shalom Ben Ramav Hu Yasei Shalom Aleinu V'Alkol Yisrael V'Emru Amen. Please rise. And join with me in the English of Ein Kelavinu. There is none like our God. There is none like our Lord. There is none like our King. There is none like our Deliverer. Who is like our God? Who is like our Lord? Who is like our King? Who is like our Deliverer? Let us give thanks to our God. Let us give thanks to our Lord. Let us give thanks to our King. Let us give thanks to our Deliverer. Blessed be our God. Blessed be our Lord. Blessed be our King. Blessed be our Deliverer. You are our God. You are our Lord. You are our King. You are our Deliverer. You are He to whom our fathers offered before you the fragrant incense. And Adon Olam, Master of the universe, reigned before any form was created. When creation came about by His will, then as King was His name proclaimed to be. And after all has ceased to be, He alone will reign in awesomeness. And He was, and He is, and shall be eternally in splendor. And He is first, and there is no second to compare to Him. To be His equal, without beginning and without end, His is the power and dominion. And He is my rock, my living Redeemer, the rock of my pain in times of trouble. And He is my banner and a refuge for me, the portion of my cup on the day I call upon Him. In His hands I entrust my spirit, in the time I sleep or am awake, and with my spirit, my body, the Lord is with me. I shall not fear. Adon Olam, I share my life. Beteren kol yitzir nivra.
The who needs see, who
Please don't forget, tonight at 6:30, we'll meet here at the synagogue for Ne'ilah, a very short service, the blowing of the shofar, and then those who would like to join us, we're going to be at Fanares Brothers at 7 o'clock, or as long as it takes us to get from here to there, and break our fast together there. And everyone is invited. Yevarechecha Adonai veYishmerecha Ya'ir Adonai panav alecha vihunecha Yisar Adonai panav alecha veyasem lecha shalom. Adonai bless you and keep you. Adonai make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. Adonai lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Hashem Yeshua Meshachinu Sar Shalom, in the name of Yeshua our Messiah, the Prince of Peace. Amen. 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 I always forget this. Is it off?